I'm Christine Corrado here in the Proactive Investors studio in New York. Joining me in the studio today is Sean Dollinger from Namaste Technologies. Sean, it's great to have you here today.
Hey, Christine. Thanks so much for having us.
So earlier last week, I had interviewed Corey Zaligson, Namaste's co-founder. He had given us a company overview, but just to remind U.S. investors, just give us another brief overview of Namaste Technologies.
We're your everything cannabis store. So if you're looking for vaporizers, cannabis, CBD, cannabis soon to be, which we'll get to in a little bit, you'll come to Namaste websites and purchase the product that you'd like. And then we use technology to enhance the buying experience. So we use AI, machine learning, a telemedicine app, and a bunch of other things to make the user experience that much better.
So Namaste is currently trading on OTC markets here in the US, but you do have plans to uplist. Proactive story was the most viewed story this week on Namaste's plan to uplist. So what can you tell us about how Namaste is pressing ahead with this uplist to the Nasdaq?
Yeah, so the lawyers are at work, obviously. They're the ones who do the heavy lifting with the regulators. And where we're at is we've got to keep working hard, hopefully get our sales license here. We've been waiting for it. It's an important milestone. So for your viewers and listeners who might not know, Namaste, we specialize in e-commerce, and we're light years ahead of anybody in the space right now. And in order to start selling cannabis online, we need a sales license. We've been waiting for the last few weeks. It should come any time now. And we hope that's the catalyst to get us to the share price needed to be able to make up the move to the Nasdaq.
So on Tuesday, shares closed at $2.73. So you're waiting on that license. Anything else you're waiting for to get it to $4?
You know, our revenue is amazing, especially when you look at our peers, like a company like Canopy. They're worth over $15 billion, and they only do about 3 times more revenue than us, and we're valued at under $1 billion. Tilray, we actually do as much revenue as them, and they're valued at $10 billion. So we're hoping that the markets catch up, see what we're really doing, and how much value there is to everything that we've worked so hard for.
So when do you see this happening?
Oh boy, that's a tough one. Can't go on record saying that, but I could guarantee everybody we're sticking with the plan. Our team is amazing. We just had this unbelievable party 2 days ago for our shareholders and investors in Montreal, where Snoopadelic came and performed, and everybody just absolutely loved it. It's hard to explain the culture. It's almost like what you see people with Apple, where they buy the Apple product, but they love the company as much. That's what we see with Namaste.
What do you see as the difference between U.S. investors versus Canadian investors in terms of getting into the cannabis market?
So I think that's a great question. Access to investment, I think, has been tough up to this point. Like somebody from the U.S. hitting the CSE markets, the Canadian Securities Exchange, it's very hard for the systems to hit Canadian dollar stocks. So that's where like an OTCQB listing comes in. But I think that's why we see Cronos Group and Tilray trading so well, because American investors have identified that this space is here to stay. It's not going anywhere. It's not a dot-com. We're here. It's happening. We're just waiting on legalization from the U.S. federal government for it to go a whole other leg up, in my opinion. So with this move, Namaste being an e-commerce play, I think U.S. investors understand e-commerce extremely well. So it should be an interesting angle for your investors and people who watch your show to put their money in something more diverse than just a company growing. You know, we're your everything cannabis store. So we're in 20 countries around the world, 30 different websites, not just one website. We've got 30 different websites. So this gives people plenty of opportunity.
Besides the uplist, anything else we can expect from Namaste in the next few months?
We're always making headlines. 2 days ago, we announced that we're expanding a distribution center in the UK to go ahead and distribute cannabis out of there. A few months ago, cannabis wasn't even looking like it was going to be legal in the UK. And here in October, looks like we'll have a whole movement on the medical side. And then who knows what that could lead to. So we're always listening. We're always looking for opportunities. And I think you could hear a lot from Namaste over the next few months.
Very exciting, Sean. Thank you so much for coming in. Looking forward to following the Namaste story. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.